Joining me now in a CNBC exclusive is Tom Rutledge. He's Charter Communications CEO. Tom, great to see you. And let's start there. You know, I'm curious, what are you seeing in terms of demand, broadband in particular? I mean, how many more people are you delivering 1 gigahertz to this year than perhaps you were last year?
Well, we had a great growth year this year. We've grown 2.3 million broadband customers since over the last 12 months. And that's really almost a million customers ahead of the kind of growth rate track we were on prior to the current situation.
And what about speeds? I mean, I'm curious, like, what are you delivering now? And is it more than you were previously? Because I would assume the demand, given all the stuff we're doing from home these days, has only grown dramatically.
Well, it has. You know, the average customer now, the average broadband-only customer is using over 600 gigs of data per month, which is significantly higher than it was previously. Now, it's gone back down a little bit as people have gone back to work, but it's still at least 20% greater than it was prior to the pandemic. And, you know, we've been on a growth rate anyway of data capacity usage by customers, and the pandemic accelerated it, but it is the long run trend anyway.
Yeah, so it speeds up the long run trend, but where do we go? I mean, are we up again? You know, people may go, many are going to go back to work, the majority, but this is a change that we're going to be living with forever, right, Tom, in terms of how many people work at home and consume a lot more.
Yeah, and it's not just work at home. All the applications that people use in their daily life, whether it's security systems, whether it's gaming, whether it's working from home or education from home, or now telemedicine from home, which a lot of people are doing, all of those things use more data. And the future products that we have, IP streaming video products, all the IP streaming video services that have been launched all use broadband and all use data capacity that we have available. So the long run trend is growth, and our networks are capable of providing that growth, both in demand on a per customer basis, but also in terms of access to the network itself. And so we have good penetration growth as a result of the quality of our products, and we have good demand growth within the products in terms of how people are using them.
Right. Well, even within that, listen, we've talked a lot in our past conversations about cord cutting. You actually added 67,000 video subs
That's
in the
true.
Last quarter, but it's not a growth business at all.
That's right.
How do you view it at this point? Is it done going down, or was that an aberration that last quarter?
Well, you know, I've always said that I thought we could grow video a little bit if we grew broadband fast enough. And that really is what's happening. We've created so many customer relationships that we're pulling through video with them as people disconnect from satellite and buy our services and buy broadband at the same time. So we're getting some growth. But the long run trends in the industry are that the big bundle is more difficult to sell. It's very expensive. Content costs are not going down, so consumer bills for big content continue to go up. And so there's a lot of pressure in the ecosystem to continue the erosion of expensive video packages. That said, they're still pretty valuable, and it's the one place you can get live TV, and it's the one place you can get sports.
Yeah.
And so, you know, how slowly it'll erode as a result of its price pressure, I'm not sure, but I think it may slow down a bit.
Well, I have noted those virtual MVPDs keep raising their prices. I mean, they're all above $65 a month now.
Well, everybody that was priced below $65 was actually losing money on every customer they created. Our average cost per customer exceeds $65 just in content cost.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.